The factor which remains in asthma management is right inhaler technique, and this is very, very important as far as very well controlled and controlled for longer duration is concerned, because majority of the patients, they don't use inhalation devices properly, and we doctors don't have that much time to teach every patient. So friends, I think you should have the knowledge and you should take some time to learn these techniques and to convey the patient or to teach the patient individually for the use of inhaler devices. Friends, incorrect inhaler technique is the important cause of uncontrolled asthma as per the GINA guidelines. So incorrect inhaler technique is seen up to around 80% of the patients, and you will not believe the poor adherence is there, which is seen in at least 50% of the patients. So inhaler technique should be taught properly and to the each asthmatic patients, which are different types of inhalers. One is MDI, that is metered dose inhaler. Second is DPI, that is dry powder inhaler, and third is nebulizer. And in our practice, we use MDI and DPI repeatedly. Nebulizers are kept only for the emergency cases, and they should be handled very properly as far as transmission of infection is concerned. Nowadays, there are new devices which are called as breathe actuated inhalers, that is BAIs, which make patients comfortable for the better inhaled medications. Now, what is the right technique for DPI, that is dry powder inhaler? DPI requires turbulence energy to deaggregate their formulations and produce a fine particle dose during the inhalation maneuver. The greater the energy imparted by the patient's inspiratory flow rate, the more effective the particle deaggregation. So, what is the right way of use of DPI? Patient should inhale as deeply and as hard as possible so that they can overcome the internal resistance and achieve the best aerosol deposition by inhalation. The greater the energy imparted by patient's inspiratory flow rate, the more the effective is the particle deaggregation. So better will be the DPI effect. Now, right technique of the MDI, that is PMDI, labeled as pressurized metered dose inhalers. Now, most pressurized metered dose inhalers, they involve users coordinating correct timing and appropriate inspiratory flow rate. So, in the use of MDIs or PMDIs, the patient's coordination is very, very important, because when they inhale the medication, they should generate the inspiratory flow synchronously with the MDI. The right technique is check the right pattern of breathing and use PMDI with the spacer. So if you use spacer along with PMDI, there will be proper inhalation of the PMDI. Now, in this slide, you will see the right pattern of breathing. Now, check the right pattern of breathing. On the left hand side, there is the device, and right hand side, there is right breathing pattern. For PMDI, slow and deep breathing. PMDI with the spacer, with tidal or slow and deep breathing. DPI, rapid and deep breathing. So, while using DPI, one should have the idea of rapid and deep breathing, and this should be taught to the patient. For breathe actuated inhalers, slow and deep breathing, and for nebulizer, it's a tidal breathing. So this is the way of different types of inhaler use. The right inhaler for right patient. So how to choose the right inhaler device for individual patients? Inhalers should be matched to the patient specifically with respect to ease of correct use, size, possibility to guide the patient through the inhalation, feedback of the dose delivered, correctly performed inhalation, availability of intelligent dose counter with the device, indication of the number of correctly performed inhalations, need for accessory devices, and definitely very important thing is inhaler reliability and cost of the inhaler. So friends, while choosing inhaler device for individual patients, one should have all these factors in mind, and accordingly you should go for the choice of inhaler device.